So hello everyone. First of all, welcome to all of you in my lecture. So today I am going to discuss about the controller tuning techniques. Okay. So if you will think about the controller tuning techniques, why we need controller tuning first? Okay. Because after selection of feedback control system, then we still suffering a problem for getting about the fixed value of or the one of the best value of the adjustable variable, that is more important. Okay, because if you will see in our process, you will see there are various types of parameters, adjustable parameters, just like the controller gain if you will see dead time, or if you will see the time constant, all these things, then these value or all these things should be appropriate for a controller, okay, for a process, okay, to work in a very efficient way. Okay, so these things to select the adjustable variable up to its best point, then we need a controller tuning, okay, after selection of the feedback control system. Okay, so in our syllabus, in our chemical engineering syllabus, there are three techniques that we have to study in the controller controller tuning technique. First is Ziegler-Nichols technique, second is quarter decay ratio technique, and third is Cohen-Kuhn method technique. Okay, so there are three types of method in which first and second Cohen-Kuhn method and Ziegler-Nichols method is very important for our gate point of view. One quarter decay ratio technique is not much more important for the gate point of view. So I will be discussing about the Cohen-Kuhn techniques in this lecture. Okay, so if you will think about the why Ziegler-Nichols technique is different from the Cohen-Kuhn technique, then Ziegler-Nichols technique is well suited for the process in which the time constant tau, that is much longer than as compared to the dead time. Okay, so if you will see, I will tell you later on tau, what is the value, what is how we define tau, and what will be the dead time for any process. But here, if you will see, if you are going want to use a Ziegler-Nichols technique, then Ziegler-Nichols techniques is more appropriate for the system having more time constant, and having time constant is longer than that of the dead time process. Okay, for second thing is that if you want to manage the process in which there is a fast system, just like flow control, temperature control, pressure control, composition control, that requires fast control. Okay, so in that condition, we can't use Ziegler-Nichols technique. So Ziegler-Nichols, there is a limitations of Ziegler-Nichols techniques. While if there is a flow measurement, temperature measurement, pressure measurement, all these are adjustable variable in a control loop, closed loop system. Okay, so here, to avoid these techniques, Ziegler-Nichols techniques, definitely we must suit it for a particular method, and that method is a Cohen-Kuhn technique, that is also called as the process reaction curve. Okay, so that we have to study in this lecture. Okay, so this is the process reaction curve, and this is applicable for open loop transfer function. Okay, I will tell you how we will be transferring, or how we will be converting the closed loop system into open loop system, and from there we will be defining various adjustable parameters, just like time constant of the process, gain of the controller, and dead time of the system or dead time of the process. These three major adjustable variables that we have to calculate from the Cohen-Kuhn techniques with the help of a open loop transfer function. Okay, so if you will see in Cohen-Kuhn techniques, then how we used to define the Cohen-Kuhn technique, how we deal in the system. If you will see, there is any process, I am just writing the process here. If this is a controller GC, okay, now this is ZF, this is ZP, this is YP, that will be the output of the process. Now what you have to do, this is any process, okay, I will tell you which types of process this will look like. Then in the controller, in Cohen-Kuhn technique, what is our main assumption? That we have to break the process. First of all, this will be a closed loop response like that. This will be a closed loop system, okay? This will be a closed loop system. And now what you have to do, this will be a set point. This will be a set point. Now, what will happen? If you are going to handle this system with the help of Cohen-Kuhn technique, then there is a major assumption in the Cohen-Kuhn technique. That Cohen-Kuhn technique tells us that just break the closed loop response from here and apply step input here at the output of the controller. This will be the controller, and you have to apply the step input out of the controller, and I am just applying the step input having magnitude of A at the output of the controller. Now understand one thing, which types of system it will give the, what will be the response of this particular system, it will see. Then what will happen first, if you have selected the process first, then second thing that in Cohen application of Cohen-Kuhn technique, or if you are going to calculate the various adjustable parameter from Cohen-Kuhn technique, then first of all you have to select the process first. Second thing is that just make the process or leave the process in a manual mode, because if you will see, as a, if you will work as a system engineer or as a process engineer in any industry, then you will see there what will happen. There are two types of functions that used to work parallelly. First is automated system and second is manual process. Okay, so if automated system is not going to control the adverse situation inside the process, then what you have to do as a design engineer, you have to make the process in the manual mode. Okay. And again manually you can adjust the parameters and again control the system. Okay, so here what will happen, just in this technique you have to make the process in the manual mode first. Second thing is that we just apply the step input at the output of the controller, and at various time of interval just try to at time t equals to t1, t2, t3, all these times just check the output of the response. Okay, so in various parameters, if you will see, the response of this particular process has been seen just like a sigmoidal curve. Because if you will see the transfer function of this particular process, that will be the output upon input, that will be equals to GF, GP and into GM, and that will comes equals to K upon tau s plus 1 into e to the power minus tau ds. So if you will see, this process is first order process and supported with time delay process, first order plus time delay system. Okay, so generally in most of the industry you will see the graph or the transfer function of the process will be look like that, and the graph or the output response of this process you will see in the process, that will be a sigmoidal curve. Okay, so if you want to draw the graph, just I am removing this transfer closed loop response, then closed loop system, then you will see the graph of this particular process will be looks like that, in this way the graph will be like that. So this graph will be look like that, in this way. Okay, so now if you will see, this is the response of yd and this is the time axis. Now what you have to do in the Cohen-Kuhn control techniques, if you will see the process here, then if you will see the curve here from this point, at a particular point what is happening over here, the curve, the slope of the curve is going to be changed at this point, at this particular point. So if the tangent, if you are going to draw, then what will happen, this tangent will cut at a particular point, this. Okay, so I am not drawing this particular thing because the diagram becomes very bulky. So what you have to understand, if you will draw, then the tangent at a particular point of inflation will give you that will cut the time axis at a particular point at t is equal to tau d, and this will be the dead time of the process. If the transfer function of the process is written like that, Gs, that is equals to K upon tau s plus 1 into e to the power minus of tau ds, then this tau ds is a delay time delay. So this will give you the if the slope of this particular, or the tangent at a particular point of inflation, that is going to cut this time axis at a particular point, that time will give you dead time of the process. Okay, for second thing is that you want to calculate the value of K. Okay, so if you will see, after the process which is going to be in the steady state, this will achieve a output steady state value of B. Just understand, I am just assuming here, this is going to reach in the final output steady value, that is B. Now what is happening, you have given an input at a particular point of time T, at a particular time t is value of A. This is the value of input. Then what will happen, if you want to calculate the value of K from Cohen-Kuhn technique, then you can write it output a steady state value upon input a steady state value. output steady state value upon input steady state value. That will give you the value of K, means controller gain of the particular process. Okay, that we have used in that particular system that I have discussed earlier in this diagram. Now that will be equal to K. That is output steady state value is B. So that will be equal to B upon input steady state value, that because at t equals to 0, at t equals to t, you have applied a step input of magnitude A, and this is a step input at t tending to infinity, that will again achieve a value of multiple part magnitude A, and this will remain there. Okay, so the input steady state value will be equal to A. So the controller gain of the process you can calculate, that is equal to output steady state value B upon input steady state value. Okay. I think up to this you all are clear now about this particular diagram. Now I am going to tell you about how will we calculate the time constant of this process. Okay, so now if you will see at the point of inflation, what you are going to see, there will be a slope of the tangent, and I am just assuming the slope of tangent is S. If you will assume the slope of tangent is S, this will be the slope of tangent. So how will we calculate the value of tau? That is, tau is equal to time constant. And if you want to define time constant, if you have studied the first order and second order process for the topic in the process dynamics and control, then you can define the time constant, the time value, or the time at which the output response of the process reaches to 63.3% of its initial output steady state value, then that time will be called as the time constant of the process. So how we can define, how we can calculate the time constant from the Cohen-Kuhn technique? So what you have to do, the time constant of the process will be equal to B upon slope of the curve. Okay, just you have to remember these things. There is no any proof, this is totally an empirical things, because there is no any theoretical basis of this particular concept. Only you have to remember three formula. First, how will you calculate the controller gain of the process? So this will be the controller gain. Second, T tau, that is time constant, that is equal to B, output steady state value that I have written over here, upon the slope of the sigmoidal curve at a particular point of inflation. Third, how will you calculate the value of tau D? Okay, so just you have to draw a tangent at a particular point of inflation, and the tangent is going to cut the time axis at a particular point, and that time will be called as the dead time of the process. Okay, so we have calculated three major adjustable parameters of a particular process, which is defined by the first order plus time delay process, and from there we have calculated three adjustable parameters, that is time constant, dead time of the process, and controller gain of the process. Okay, so I have explained these things very categorical way. If you will understand the difference between the Ziegler-Nichols techniques and Cohen-Kuhn techniques, then you will be able to understand why we are using Cohen-Kuhn techniques in place of the Ziegler-Nichols techniques. Already I have told you, if there is several variables just like pressure, controller, temperature or composition that requires very fast control, then we can't use the Ziegler-Nichols technique. So in that condition, we have to switch from Ziegler-Nichols techniques to the Cohen-Kuhn techniques. That will give flexibility to calculate all these parameters in a very easy way. Okay, so Ziegler-Nichols techniques we will be using on that place where the process requires or the adjustable parameters requires a long time for the control. Okay, but in where we will use the Cohen-Kuhn techniques, this objective can be asked in the GATE examination. The process or the if in the process there is a adjustable variable just like pressure, temperature, controller or composition which requires a faster control, there we can use the Cohen-Kuhn technique as compared to the Ziegler-Nichols techniques. Okay, so if you will see from this particular concept, the numerical question rarely used to be asked. Once GATE has asked questions on this particular concept, that they are given the value of ultimate or output steady state value of the process first, that was value of R they have written, and input they have applied in the process was P, and they have told just calculate the time process or calculate the transfer function of the process. So from here you will calculate the K will be equal to B by the substitute here. Now you have calculated tau, you will get the transfer function of this particular process for the sigmoidal curve or the process which contains time delay first order system, that will be equals to I am writing, I am using all these various parameters as a 7 parameter for this process. So you will get, so near GS that is equals to K. K is B by A. B upon A upon tau. Tau is equals to B upon M. Where B is equals to what? The output steady state value of the process. Okay. Now, B upon S. And this is S. This is will be the slope. At which point? The point of inflation. Okay. On the sigmoidal curve into this will be S. This S is tau S. Okay. Now plus 1 into e to the power minus of tau ds. And where, how will calculate tau ds? From the graph only. If graph is given, then definitely you can understand which will be the tau d value. So if you will see in the graph in the sigmoidal curve, then I have to draw a graph in this way. This is a sigmoidal curve. Okay, so if you will draw, then the graph will be like that. So this particular point will give you the value of tau d. So this will be easily calculated by the graph. So there is no any theoretical proof for this particular process. This is totally empirical. So my dear friend, I have completed the controller tuning techniques for the process, that is Cohen-Kuhn techniques. Okay, so in my next lecture I will be discussing about the Ziegler-Nicholas techniques for the controller tuning, and after that we will compare both the techniques, which is more better and which is less important for our industrial point of view. Okay, so thanks for this lecture too.